Good morning students, this is the continuation for the previous session. So in the previous session we discussed about input stream reader class, and in this section we are going to discuss scanner class. I already told, so we can read the input from the keyboard in Java using two classes. One is input stream reader class, another one is scanner class. Already input stream reader class we are discussed in the previous session with some example program, and in this class we are going to see scanner class. So what is scanner class, how to get the input from the keyboard using the scanner class, we'll discuss. The scanner is a class from the util package, java.util package. if we want to use the scanner class, first we have to import java.util package, then only you can use scanner class. After importing this class, then you can create the object for the scanner class, and we are going to connect this object to the keyboard, that is system.in. after that you can read the input one by one from the keyboard. And the scanner is a class which are going to use to scanning the input values from the keyboard. The input values, either primitive values or strings, it can read either primitive values or strings in the form of input, that is going to scanning. It will going to scan automatically whatever the input you are going to type on the console, that will going to scan automatically and it will store into the scanner object. After that we are going to get one by one in the form of tokens. Okay, it will going to store in the form of tokens. So then we are going to get one by one token using some methods. Understood? So the scanner, scanner is a easy way to read the input from the keyboard or from the console or from any file. So using the scanner class, you can read the data from the console or any text file. So now we'll see what are the steps we have to follow to read the input from the keyboard or to scan the input from the keyboard. Steps. See, what are the steps? Number one, step one, first import the util package to use the scanner class. Import java.util, import java.util package. How to import? See, import java.util package to use scanner class. So import java.util.scanner or import java.util.asterisk. See, you can import either these two ways. So import java.util.scanner. So here I am importing only the scanner class because I required only scanner class, no any other class I am using, only scanner class I am using. So directly you can import the particular class like that. Scanner is a class from util package. So util is a package from the Java package, like that. So import is a keyword. Or import java.util.asterisk. Asterisk means what? All. Asterisk means what? All. So it is importing all the classes from the util package. Suppose if you are going to using many classes from the util package, then you can use asterisk. If you are using particular class, only single class, then directly you can import the class like that. This is the step one. Next, step two. So create the object for scanner class and connect it to the keyboard, that is system.in. Create object to scanner class and connect it to keyboard. Keyboard means what? System.in. So how to create object for scanner class and how to connect that to the keyboard? See, what is the statement for that? Scanner Yes, capital letter, because it is inbuilt class from the util package. Scanner SC is equal to new scanner of system.in. See here, SC is capital, system is a class. See, scanner is a class from the util package, so it is inbuilt class, so that we have to write the first letter capital letter for class. Then SC is object. How to create object for class using the new operator? Now object is created. Once the object is created, so then we are going to connect this object to the input, that is system.in keyboard. So now keyboard is connected to the scanner class object. Now we can read the input from the keyboard. Next, step 3. Suppose user enter values from keyboard or from console. Enter values from keyboard or console, then those values will be stored. Those are stored in the form of tokens. Tokens in SC object. See, generally if you are going to give input from the keyboard, so those input values are going to store in the SC object in the form of what? Tokens, in the form of tokens. So if you want to receive the tokens one by one, we have to use the some methods. What are the methods? Suppose, you know, the user is entered some string. User is entered some string on the console or on the console or from the keyboard. Then those input it will go into scan. It will go into scan automatically, and that will go into store in the SC object as tokens. As tokens. If you want to read string, what is the method? To read string, what is the method? For example, string str is equal to sc dot next. What is the method we are using? Next. So sc dot next. So using this method, you can get the string from the sc token, sc object. So next. If you want to read integer, int age, sc dot next int. Sc dot next. So here I is capital letter. So the next int is a method from the scanner class. If you want to use this method from the scanner class, we have to use that object. What is the object for scanner class? Sc. So that sc dot next int. So then it will call the method and it will read the, it will get the integer from the scanner object. Suppose if you want to get the long value. For example, long or any some long value, big number. So sc dot next long, sc dot next long. So suppose if you want to get the long value from the sc object, you have to use sc dot next long. Then it will get and store into the variable big number from long. Now, if you want to float average, sc dot next float, sc dot next float. Here, next float is a method, and it will go into read. It will go into get the float value and will go into store in the variable age. Similarly, double amount. Sc dot next double, sc dot next double. So like that we can get the one by one tokens from the scanner object sc using the methods. So this is the process to scan the values from the console or from the text file using the scanner class. Now we will see one example program how to read the input from the console or any text file using the scanner class. Program for scanning input from console using scanner class. Okay. First, so if you want to use scanner class, I told already you have to import util package. Import java dot util dot scanner, or you can use what, asterisk, or you can use asterisk. Next, class name is scanner demo. Scanner demo, class name. Then main method, public static void main string arguments. Then main method started. Now create the object for scanner class. Scanner SC is equal to new scanner. SC is capital letter, and connect it to the input keyboard system.in. SC is capital. So create the object for scanner class using the new operator, that is SC. Now object is created, that object is connected to the input device, that is a keyboard. Now we can give the input. So first ask the input. How to ask the input? System.out.println. System.out.println. Here system is a predefined class, S is capital letter. Enter your name. So how to read that name? Name is a string. How to read the string? I already told what is the method. Next, string name is equal to sc.next. I told already, so if you are going to give input, automatically it will scan and it will store into the scanner object SC in the form of tokens. If you want to get the tokens, you have to use method next, sc.next. It can get the input string from the scanner object and store into the variable name of type string. Next, another input, system.out.println. Enter age. So age is a what, integer. How to get the integer token from the scanner? How to get the method is what, sc.next int. Then it will get the integer value from the scanner object and store into the variable age of type integer. Next, System.out.println. Enter gender. Enter your gender. That is what, character. Gender is equal to sc.next char, C capital letter. So now all three inputs are ready into the some variables. Now display the output. How to display the output? Using system.out.println. System.out.println name is equal to name. Name is existing in which variable? Name. So name is equal to name. First here output will be displayed. Name is equal to some name, some xx. Whatever the name you are given, that name. For example, if you are given the name, for example, any name, that name will be displayed. Next, system.out.println age is equal to some age. Age is available in which variable? Age. That is the variable name. So age is equal to some age. Then another system.out.println gender. Gender is equal to gen. So next gender is equal to some gender will be displayed. This is the output. So finally close the main method, close the class. Close the main method and close the class. So this is the example for reading the or scanning the input from the keyboard using the scanner class. Understood? Previous one is input stream reader class and this one is scanner class. Using these two classes, you can read the input from the keyboard. Understood? If you have any doubts, you can ask me through WhatsApp and try to execute this program also and type this program in the notepad and compile and run as per the given instructions in the previous sessions. Okay? Understood? First import the scanner class, after that from the util package, then class, class name, then main method. After that main method, create the object for scanner class and connect it to the keyboard, that is system.in. Then ask the first input, enter your name. So automatically if you enter the name in your console, then automatically it will scan and store into the SC object. How? In the form of token. How to get the token? How to get the token? If you want to get the token as string, then we have to use sc.next. sc.next. So anyway, name is a string. So if you want to get the string from the token, you have to use sc.next. Then it will get the string as name and it will store into the variable name. Then if you want to read the next input, ask the input, enter age. So the age basically integer. So I want to get the integer value from the SC object. How to get the token? sc.next int. It will get the integer value and store into the variable age. Next, start the third output, third input, enter your gender. So to read the gender, so I want to store into the character. So next char, so I have to get from the tokens as a character and store into the gn. All three will be displayed. So name, age, gn, the variables, whatever the variables you are use, those variables you have to concatenate with this quoted string, double quoted string, using the plus operator. So then this will be concatenated and displayed like that. Understood? So thank you.